Large marine ecosystems, or LMEs, are relatively large areas of ocean space of about 200,000 square kilometers or more. Adjacent to the continents, these waters are sometimes defined by ocean currents and undersea topography, productive fisheries, and natural food chain interactions. These ecosystems are transboundary in nature by virtue of interconnected currents and movement and migration of marine living resources across boundaries. The world's 66 LMEs are the most highly productive areas of the oceans. They harbor biodiversity and provide important ecosystem services and benefits, including livelihoods, food security, carbon sequestration, and storage and recreational opportunities. Taken together, LMEs provide more than $12 trillion per year in non-market goods and services. A combination of anthropogenic and natural pressures is degrading the health and productivity of LMEs, compromising the sustainability of LME market and non-market ecosystem services. These pressures include nutrient over-enrichment, marine pollution, ocean acidification and sea temperature rise, unsustainable fishing, and invasive species introductions. Since 1995, the Global Environment Facility, GEF, has invested in projects in 23 of these ecosystems. A cornerstone of the GEF's LME programming is the ecosystem-based management concept, which involves a paradigm shift from single species or sector focus to management of an entire ecosystem. It also integrates a science-to-policy process. It encourages neighboring countries to manage their shared marine ecosystem along natural rather than political boundaries. Operationalizing this concept is the modular LME approach. The models are indicators on changes in productivity, fish and fisheries, pollution and ecosystem health, socioeconomics, and governance to support management practices. In most LMEs, participating countries first prepare a formal transboundary diagnostic analysis, or TDA, through a consultative process in which they determine environmental problems, their root causes and impacts. The Strategic Action Program, or SAP, then translates shared commitment and vision into action to resolve priority threats at the national and transboundary level, as well as institutional mechanisms. The GEF's LME-based programming has in several cases been transformational in supporting sustainable use and highly catalytic in terms of leveraging both public and private financial resources. One such case is in the Benguela Current LME, which crosses the waters of South Africa, Namibia, and Angola. Here in the Benguela, fisheries, oil, and mining sectors are key contributors to economic development. The Benguela TDA identified the major problems as a loss of valuable shared commercial fish stocks, harmful algal growth, killing coral reef and fish, invasive species, and land-based pollutants. With the TDA as their foundation, the countries then work together to prepare and agree upon an SAP, outlining the necessary policy, legal and institutional changes needed.
The Strategic Action Program helped the countries to manage the transboundary resource by actually engaging with the other party on the other side of sort of the transboundary line. And that's really crucial because only in that way can they integrate these actions fully into the domestic plans, programs and strategies.
This science-to-policy process helped to form the Benguela Current Commission. It was to be the first multi-country commission of its kind for the protection of a large marine ecosystem. In 2013, another milestone was achieved, the signing of a legally binding convention for the protection of the LME. The countries have achieved significant results. These countries shared scientific research, reduced harm to wildlife, prevented exploitive fishing, proposed new marine protected areas, and reduced land-based sources of pollution. A concerted global effort to restore and protect the world's LMEs will reap the environmental benefits of a much healthier ocean. It will protect hundreds of millions of ocean-dependent livelihoods and economies. It will lead to sizable transformations in a number of key ocean use sectors, stimulating economic growth and sustainable development. The LME approach has provided a rallying point for countries to cooperate in dealing with problems relating to the utilization of transboundary marine resources. As a regional framework and science-informed process, it can be an engine for achieving the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development, especially Goal 14, Conserve and Sustainably Use the Oceans, Seas and Marine Resources for Sustainable Development.